The purpose of explaining the Gibbs-Donnan equilibrium is to provide a basis for understanding how a cell membrane can develop an electrical charge. Cells contain many impermeable anions, so it is easy to understand that a Gibbs-Donnan equilibrium would occur at the membrane dividing the inside and the outside of a cell. Even if the cell membrane did not have unique properties, such as differential ion channels and pumps, the presence of the impermeable anions would produce an unequal distribution of the permeable ions. Let us show some of the calculations and also describe a bit of membrane biology to assist in explaining this phenomenon. We will begin with the distribution of cations and anions at the start and again at equilibrium. To make the system more like a real cell membrane, we will consider side 1 as the inside of a cell, and side 2 as the outside of the cell, and the semipermeable membrane represents the cellular plasma membrane. The size of the electrical potential can be calculated for the distribution of ions by using the Nernst equation. Here is the Nernst equation. The parameters for the Nernst equation are as follows. R is the universal gas constant. T is the temperature expressed in degrees Kelvin. Z is the valence of the ion of interest, including its positive or negative polarity. F is Faraday's constant. The concentrations of the ions are expressed as millimolar, and the other constants must be adjusted accordingly. For positive univalent ions, RT divided by ZF simplifies to a value of 25 millivolts at 20 degrees centigrade. Likewise, the natural log can be simplified to 2.3 times the log to the base 10. Therefore, RT divided by ZF times 2.3 simplifies to 58 millivolts at 20 degrees centigrade. If the ion is chloride, then the value is minus 58 millivolts. Based on the simplification of the Nernst equation, the electrical potential for a cation across a cell membrane is equal to 58 times the log of the ion concentration outside of the cell divided by the ion concentration inside the cell. Let us use the Nernst equation to calculate the membrane potential for the potassium ion from our example of the Gibbs-Donnan equilibrium. The potassium potential equals 58 times the log of 80 divided by 160. This converts to 58 times the log of 0.5. Log to the base 10 of 0.5 equals minus 0.3. Therefore, the potassium membrane potential equals 58 times minus 0.3, which equals minus 17 millivolts, with the outside of the cell being positive.